This video will demonstrate how we can prepare a slide for gram staining. So I'm actually going to use a culture from an agar plate, but you could use a broth culture. So I'm just going to firstly label a slide with the name of the bacteria and my name and also the date. Just put it on the side of the slide. So I prepared a 16 streak dilution from a broth suspension to produce this E. coli plate. You can see some nice single colonies there. If you're using a culture from an agar plate, you'll need to put a drop of water onto your microscope slide first, and you use the inoculating loop to do that. If you're using the broth solution, well, that's already in a liquid, so you don't need to have that drop of water. But so I've got water prepared in a dropper, but even still, I'm going to use the inoculating loop to put the drop on. Firstly, don't forget that you need to flame the loop first to make it aseptic. And then you simply just move the loop around the microscope slide just to smear it across. Next thing we need to do is take our culture of bacteria from our agar plate, and we're going to use probably one, if not two, of the single cultures and put that on the plate. Maybe if you just use the one culture, it's just not going to be enough, so probably just grab two of the small cultures. Okay, so we're going to use our inoculating loop just to smear it around. It does tend to want to come back to a droplet, so you want to try and smear it as best you can, just like that. Then we need to flame our loop one more time, and then we can put that away. Now the next thing is we need to heat fix the specimen. So we're going to do that by wafting it through the Bunsen burner flame several times. You need to be a little bit careful because obviously the glass is a conductor of heat. And once you've done that, you're just going to put it onto the rack. I've made a bit of a makeshift rack there with some glass rod and a takeaway container. That's really all you need. So we want to wait maybe a couple of minutes until that's dried. You can pass it through the Bunsen burner again if you need to, and wait until it's nice and dry. So now it's time to start adding the reagents. The first one we use is the crystal violet, and we put 1 to 2 drops of the crystal violet on our specimen, and then we let it sit for maybe somewhere between 10 and 60 seconds before we then do a gentle rinse to rinse it off. So we're going to use the distilled water in the distilled water bottle just to rinse it off. Do that very, very gently, not straight on top of your specimen. In fact, just above the specimen and let it run down. So we're just trying to get rid of any of the excess. The next step is to add the Lugol iodine, which is a color fixer. So just a drop of that. Let it sit for 10 to 60 seconds. And then we're going to wash that off as well. Gently wash it off with the wash from the distilled water bottle. So again, gently washing it off with the distilled water bottle. Again, not straight over the specimen, just above, and let it wash through. The next reagent we use is the decolorizer, which is the alcohol. Just a couple of drops through. We're trying to clean that off and remove the excess purple. So decolorize it if you like. So just gently rinse that and then place it down again. The final reagent that we add is the counterstain, and that's the safranin. So again, we add several drops of that. Let it sit for between 10 to 60 seconds, and then we're going to wash that off as well. So we're going to wash that off, and then once we've done that, we're going to place the slide down for several minutes until it dries. Then we can put a cover slip on and then put under the microscope and have a look at the color we see. A positive test is purple, that means it's gram positive, and the negative test is the pink color, and that's for gram negative. Good luck.